Ann Perry, and today we're going to be talking about that time of year again. You know it. It's Happy Valentine's Day. It's soon upon us, right? So not everybody is super pumped about Valentine's Day. I'll give you that. So let's talk about why that is, because Valentine's Day seems to be a super pumped up holiday or occasion or whatever that, don't you find that there's just a whole lot of hype around it? And there's a lot of pressure for us to rise to that Hallmark occasion, like we're supposed to be something out of one of those Hallmark films. It's like a greeting card moment all the time. The fact is, guys, not everybody enjoys Valentine's Day. So how many times have you found yourself standing in front of the card rack, trying to find a card that captures how you're feeling? And you sit there and you pull them out and you read them and you look at them. And you know what? That card you're obligated to buy, I'm willing to bet it might not even be there. As best as I know, there has never been a card that says, Happy Valentine's Day, even if I'm just not feeling it, just not into it. So let's get real here just for a moment on this sacred day. Let's take a look at what this means. So February 21st is actually a 7 universal month. Okay, because we're in a 5 universal year plus February, which is a 2, makes it a 7 universal month. So what does that mean? So this is a time when we're all going to need to have time alone. We need space. We need to have time out. Okay, so this is not something a box of chocolates is going to fix. It won't change it. It is what it is. Okay, so the 7 vibration is asking you to really figure out, what do you want? And that can include, what kind of relationship do you want to be in or not? The 7 vibration keeps you in your head, and it's guaranteed, I promise you, it will cause a lot of confusion because you're not in your heart space. How ironic is that? The whole heart month of February being Valentine's Day, we're all in our heads, not our hearts. So the 7 is asking you to always second guess your decisions. Are you sure about that? What are you thinking? What do you want? Where do you want to go? Who do you want to be with? And on and on and on. So many of you have been trapped inside your homes with your partners only to be questioning if this relationship is really what you even want, right? It's getting a little bit old sometimes. So here are the facts that I know on relationships. People are always drawn to us for a reason. Okay, there's always a reason why we are drawn towards people. There are contracts that exist between us that were determined and decided upon long before we even chose to incarnate together. So relationships with others are designed to help us to learn more really about ourselves rather than them. It's really an all about us moment. Your partner's unresolved junk in the trunk is a mirror of who you, for you to see your own junk in your own trunk. So we draw people towards us so that we can learn various lessons and various aspects of ourselves. That's why it's tough sometimes. So sometimes it can feel like a grade school experiment. You know, the one we used to play with magnets that all went wrong? Kind of feels like that sometimes. So your close relationships are those from a soul family. You've been together in previous lifetimes. So you agreed to work out your stuff this time around. Damn, right? Sometimes that just doesn't even make sense why we choose the partners that we choose. But we do for a reason, and there's a reason why we're together. So you strategically chose these people in your life so that you could work out lessons you didn't quite get right in your previous lifetime. I know, right? It just seems absurd. But karma can be a bitch sometimes, right? True enough. So it's not uncommon for a relationship to end once the lesson has been learned. That's really common. I see it all the time, right? When you really examine it, you realize, oh yeah, okay, that's what I was intended to learn from this. So it's always a gift, right? Sometimes hard to see. So what is the best way to get through February of 2021? Well, first of all, you want to honor the fact that you and everyone else are supposed to be in their timeout chairs right now. That's what you're feeling like, okay? So this is not an all about you moment. Well, of course, unless you're an Aries like me, and then everything's all about us. I'm kidding, of course. But it is a time when you want to get outside and get out of your head, get into your heart. Take time out to be in nature, to release any anxieties that you might be feeling, go talk to a tree, go talk to a rock, go talk to a bird, whatever. Take time out to connect to the divine, whatever the divine is to you, okay? Meditate. Take some time out to meditate. Pray. Talk to spirit. You know what? Whenever we're feeling anxious about anything, it's because we've unplugged from a source that's bigger than us who holds all the answers, okay? So accept that box of chocolates this month and just enjoy every piece of it because you deserve it. Take some time out and just enjoy it. If you're feeling confused about your relationship, you might not know that my 90-minute readings always allow you to explore one other person, right? So if you're kind of confused about the relationship and where it's going, there's a possibility it's just a cycle you're going through that's causing you some grief. So why don't we take a look at what the future holds for you and your partner moving forward? That might be a really good thing to do because you might just get a little bit of a resolve from it. If you're thinking about finally just doing you, finally becoming who you want to be rather than being whoever else everybody else wants you to be, I've got just one spot left in my March business coaching program called Just Do You, okay? So if you possibly might be feeling just a little bit tired of doing a job that you hate just to earn a living, we've all done it, right? Maybe you're working your ass off for someone else's dreams to come true, right? Maybe it's their vision and you're working for them. Maybe you're tired of having a ceiling over your head on your income. You can only earn so much money. You're working your butt off, but you're only ever going to make this much. Maybe you've been stifling your creative passion. Oh my God, that's so hard. Maybe you're feeling like you aren't making a difference in the world and you have this passion that you really want to make a difference every day, but you're just not feeling it. Maybe you're being who you think everyone wants you to be rather than being you. So maybe it's just time to be just you, right? Just do you for a change. Stop being that round peg that fits into that square hole because it doesn't, right? If you guys want to learn a little bit more about this, I have a program. It's a 6-week program set up for people who are really passionate about getting ahead, about having their own business, about putting it out there, but maybe you just don't know where to start. I tell you, I have experienced a lot of trials and tribulations in the course of the years that it's taken me to get to be where I'm at, but I am so incredibly grateful for the success that I have experienced. And I want to tell you, it's been huge success. And if I can just help you to have as much success as me, if not more, then my work here is done. I honestly, guys, this is what I want to do. I want to help you get there. So if you have something that you're really passionate about, but you just don't even know how to begin, maybe you've got a bunch of limiting beliefs that are holding you back. Maybe you just need to learn how to get up on YouTube. Maybe you just need to learn a little bit more about social media and how you can play a part there. You might want to check this out. This is a really unique opportunity because the way that I coach through this program is using your full numerology chart. No one's doing this, okay? I am looking at your soul's contract. I see what you're good at. I see what you're going to be challenged with. I know when to start. I know when to stop. I know when to hold back because I can see it in your chart. So every week we're going to be looking at your chart and giving you some ideas on how we can really navigate through what it is you're supposed to be doing in your lifetime. How long are you going to wait? Like how much longer are you going to feel the pain of working for somebody else, right? So I just invite you to check it out. It's on my website, www.annperrynumerologist.com. I've got one opening left in March. I'm only taking a couple of people a month. I've only got one space left and then we'll be looking into April. So you might want to even get on the mailing list so that you'll get a heads up as to when the next opening opens up, or drop me an email, ann@annperrynumerologist.com, and let me know you want to be on the waiting list. So that's it for now, guys. I am hoping that you are creating your very best day ever. Take care. Bye for now.